In 4B, we want to show that the probability of survival solves a certain differential equation. And in order to do that, it may be helpful to recall that we've actually found a differential equation for the survival probability in this exercise set. And that is the result from 2C, where we have that the left derivative of delta multiplied by c is equal to lambda multiplied by delta of u minus lambda multiplied by the integral from u to u from the left of the survival probability in u minus y integrated with respect to the distribution of the claim sizes. Now, since the claim size distribution is gamma and therefore continuous, we don't need to bother with the minus here or the differentiation between this being left or right derivative. So that's nice. And we can actually already see here that the lambda multiplied by delta u that we have in this result is in this part of the equation. So the only thing that we really need to show is that this part is equal to this part. So we want to show that. Can I make a nice box? Yes, I can. We want to show that this and this are two things that are equal. So let us try to do that. By 2C, it suffices to show the following, that minus lambda multiplied by the integral from 0 to u of delta of u minus y integrated with respect to the distribution function, which in this case is continuous, and therefore we have the density that we can just multiply inside here. We want to show that this is equal to whatever is inside the red box. So let us just call that star. We want to show that this integral is equal to whatever is inside the red box. And in order to do that, what we will do is we will use a bit of integration by substitution. Now we've done that so often now that I think you guys are probably quite sure of the fact that I can just take this and write that it is equal to minus lambda multiplied by the integral from 0 to u, because when you, so let us just say what we do here is we substitute s for u minus y, because basically what happens here is when you do that, you will have to flip the boundaries around, but at the same time, your dy becomes a minus ds, and that minus will flip the boundaries right back again. So what you get is just delta of s multiplied by alpha squared, and then you have y, where by this substitution, y is equal to u minus s. And then you have e to the minus alpha u multiplied by e to the minus alpha s ds. And I guess you can already see where this is going, right? I mean, this is headed precisely where we want it to head, which is you have the minus lambda u, which is exactly what you want for this first expression here. e to the minus alpha u, and then you have the integral from 0 to u delta of, well, we integrate with respect to s, but that doesn't make any difference. Alpha square e to the, is that alpha? Oh yeah, sorry. This should be a plus, right? Because it's e to the minus alpha multiplied by u minus s, so this will be a plus. So e to the alpha s ds, and then we have minus s, so there's a minus here and a minus here, that becomes a plus lambda, and we can take e to the minus alpha u out here as well. The integral from 0 to u delta of s alpha squared, and then the s e to the alpha s ds, and this is equal to squ star. So therefore, we have shown that the survival probability in this case satisfies exactly this equation up here, which is just a special case of the general differential equation we found in 2C. Now, in 4C, we will have to differentiate a bit because we don't like the fact that there is an integral here and the derivative here. It's not that easy to solve. But by differentiating this entire thing, we can remove the integral. And it turns out that by differentiating again, we can remove some more terms entirely, which we will try to do in the next video.